Hi, this is Bill Raymond. I'm looking at one of my YouTube videos right now, and you can see I have this chapter scrubber on YouTube, so people can easily find the content that they're looking for and select it to get to that point. You can do that too using Descript. Takes a little bit of work. I'm going to show you how to do it. Before we get started, I want to acknowledge that the inspiration for this video came from CRISTI COTOVAN, I hope I got the name correctly, who you can find on the Descript community on Discord. Let me quickly walk you through how you set up chapters so you understand what we're trying to accomplish. First, you just go into YouTube Studio and upload your video. Then, in the description, you type in whatever you want, but then you set aside an area for the chapters. I usually put them at the end, but they don't have to be there. Next, you inform YouTube that you're working with chapters by defining the 0-second mark in your video, the beginning of the video, and giving that some sort of a title. In this case, I'm using the word introduction, which is very common amongst most YouTube videos. Next, you just add the timestamps and the descriptions for all of the other chapters you want to drive your viewer to. There are just a few rules you need to follow. Every chapter needs to be on a brand new line right underneath the previous one. They need to have the timestamp with the space and then the chapter name, and they must go in chronological order. You cannot have the same timestamp twice, and the chapters should be short and concise because the person watching your video may not be able to see all of the text if it goes on for too long. A little house cleaning before we get started. You are going to need Descript on your computer, so go ahead and download that now with the link that you see on the screen. Also, if this is your first time using Descript, then this may not be too familiar with you, so you might want to check out this other video that I show that shows you how to work with Descript first. Okay, let's get started. Okay, I'm in Descript. I imported a video, and I'm on the transcription view. I don't need to be looking at the video for setting this up. So I'm just going to increase the size of my screen a little bit here. And what we want to do is start at the 0-0 point. So I'm going to make sure my cursor is right at the very beginning of the audio. And then I'm going to type the letter M for marker. And you can see it automatically puts some text in. Notice that the video still starts at 0-0, even with this marker above it. We're not adding extra space or time in the video. We're just putting a chapter title in here. So I'll type the word introduction. Remember, introduction is common, but you don't have to type that. Now your job is pretty easy. All you need to do is go through, listen to the audio, and add your markers. I can see here that I'm talking about the drive view. So I'm just going to go ahead here to the front of this paragraph, type M for marker, and type the drive view. And I'll continue doing this for the rest of my video until I have all the markers. I'll see you in a second when that's done. Okay, as you can see, I have my markers all set up. One of the cool things about these markers is someone watching my video from beginning to end, they may not skip around, but when they come back, they might say, "How did they create that project again?" And there's that section right there. All right, so now let's go ahead and get this out to a text file. So I'm going to go to the File menu, choose Export, and then I'm going to choose Text as my option. Now what I want to do is only select 3 options. So if you have other things selected here, you're going to deselect them. So we only want to have Include Markers in the Output options. And then in the Timestamp options, we want the 60-second time intervals, and then we don't want anything else aside from markers. Also, up at the format section, make sure you choose TXT, plain text. Now go ahead and press the export button. I'm going to export this to my desktop using this file name, and I'll click the save button. Now, as you can see on the bottom right, it says text export completed, and there's an open item. And if I double click on that, I can see the file. When you double click on the file, it's just going to bring you to the desktop and it's going to show you the file. So your user interface might look slightly different than mine, depending on your setup on your Mac or PC, but I'm just going to go ahead and double click on this. Okay, now I have this open full screen on my Mac, so it might look a little funny here, but really what you're looking at is the same transcript from Descript. However, it has the markers with the timestamp next to it, and that's what we're looking for. Now, there's a lot more information that we don't want here, and also that YouTube will not like if we use it. First, these brackets need to go, these left and right brackets. And then also, everything underneath these dashes, which kind of separate each one of the individual markers, each one of the chapters, that needs to go too. So let me just quickly do that. I'll just show you how I do this manually. You can follow along. I'm just going to select text and delete things. I'm pressing the standard keys on my keyboard to clear things out. And I can also select these things with my mouse, right? I can click and hold and drag. This is all the same for the PC or the Mac. And then just kind of delete these things as I go. And you can see, this will just take me a few minutes to kind of get through them all and finally get the output that I'm looking for. Okay, I have YouTube Studio up on the left and I have my chapter markers on the right. Let's go ahead and add those to one of our videos. I'll just go ahead and select this Descript video here. You can see I already typed a description, but I don't have chapter markers. I'm going to go ahead and select all of these chapter markers and copy them. And then I'll come down over here and paste them. And then I'll click the Save button. And that's all there is to it. Next time someone watches your video, they'll see those chapter markers. Now you remember having to edit that text file. That can get a little cumbersome and it's prone to mistakes. So I created a little script that you can run that will automatically strip that file of all this extraneous text and give you the chapter file. Now I am using macOS Monterey or greater, and Apple ships a really cool product called Shortcuts. It's on your computer, just search for it and you'll find it. You could create shortcuts that do anything, like turn your lights on and off in a smart home situation, convert a document to PDF, things like that. But I created one that takes the Descript text file and turns it into YouTube chapters. You can see right here, here's my shortcut. If I double click on it, you can see all it does is it takes the input of the file, looks for all that extraneous text and clears it out, and then allows you to save it to a new file. As a matter of fact, you can run this on macOS, iPadOS, and your phone. But I am not going to show you how to build this exactly here in this video. If you go to the comments, I'll show you some of the details. However, I've already created it. So look right now for the link to download this onto your Mac. And then you can put that on your computer and give it a shot. Here's the good news about those shortcuts is you don't need to use a shortcut app. All you need to do is just go to the file that you want to work with. In this case, I have it up here. I'm in my Finder and I'm looking at the file. This is on my desktop. You can see here's all of that text that's included in it. And all I need to do is right click, go to Quick Actions, and choose Descript to YT Chapters. I'll go ahead and select that. And once I do, you can see a little dialog box. And I know it's a little awkward because it's not asking you for a file name or anything, but what it's trying to do is save the file somewhere. And in this case, I'm going to save it to my desktop. So I'll click Open, which, by the way, means save. It's just a little Mac thing. There. Now the file is saved. And if I come over here, you could see it says 0/0/00. That's just the first few characters of the first line of the file, but the name of the text file doesn't matter. What matters is, look, now you just have the text that you can copy and paste. The super geeky way to edit these files and do them in either Windows or Mac is to use a regular expression. Now, regular expressions are a little complicated, they're a little confusing to read, but there's some products out there that allow you to use them. One of them, my favorite, is to use Visual Studio Code. You can download that from code.visualstudio.com. Now, this is a free product, and yes, it's an advanced tool for software development, but you can also use it to do simple things like clean up a text file. So here I have Visual Studio Code installed, and I've opened the file up from my desktop that Descript created. What I'm going to do is come over here to the text editor and do a command or control F for find. And I'm going to paste this command in. Now, yes, it's here on your screen, but you can also copy and paste this from the comments in this video. Now, when you paste this command in, it's going to say, what's going on? I don't see anything. Well, all you need to do is come over here to regular expressions, which is that star with a dot next to it. And you can see now that it's selecting almost all of that text. And if I click the little arrow here, I'll just say replace with nothing and click that. There, we've almost completely cleared out the entire text with the blink of an eye. Now, there's another one that we need to add. So I'll just come back over here into the Finder and paste again. And once again, I'll just do a replace. Now, as I said, we're going to get rid of those brackets. So I'm just going to copy some code over here and paste that in. There. And I'll do another replace. And there. I am ready to just take and copy and paste that code over to YouTube. Thank you for watching this video. If you want more like this, please like, comment, and click the bell to support my channel.